a gunshot in the late night. The atmosphere at detention center was particularly eerie on the night of execution. Hundreds of death row were shot on the execution ground, but in the early days there were no anesthesia during execution. Unlike today, after few shots, everything can return to peace. Caught the death row off guard and aimed at them directly, but not every shot can be so accurately.
那时候因为没有注射麻药，如果枪打到人，人没有死完的话，人会很痛苦。然后亏了，大哥丢，哦，然后那个人就一直哀叫，哦，我打的是金条，一下气了一个一个一直挣扎。One
time, when a female death row was executed, the bailiff shot from behind her, but not a single shot was killed. The following scene was unforgettable for all people present.
那个女生竟然大叫，马上在地上就开始爬。 以前那个沙队上还有一些草皮，抓着那个草皮劈头上打呀。那个时候法警进来追上去，在开第二枪的时候，因为他在动，当然是没打到，抢过那个枪过来就赶快对着他就砰砰砰砰，才把那个女死囚执行死刑这样。所以以前早期不打麻药问题也很大。This
execution method obviously was not humane enough. In recent years, when executions, death row would have been given anesthesia, causing them to fall asleep first, so that the final time wouldn't be so harsh. But there are exceptions. Not every execution can be completed peacefully after anesthesia. Since 1982, the Wu Xin and his accomplices had committed many random homicides, including the murder of sentries and many robbery and murder cases. In just a few years, at least 14 people had been killed. Wu was sentenced to 10 death sentences, setting a record in judicial history. In 1988, Wu stepped onto the execution ground.
你知道吴兴华那个时候，他是自己要求不打麻药，因为他说他已经皈依佛教了，他已经知道什么可以让自己的灵魂出体呀。But
when we checked with the detention center, the response was that Wu did get anesthetic during the execution. But regardless of whether it was done or not, the situation was not right when the first shot was fired.
执行当中，除了打麻药以外，啊，一个年轻法警先开第一枪。那这位收容人一枪开下去之后，当场有哀嚎惨叫声。啊，年轻法警这个时候有一点被吓到，所以他又开不下去第二枪。后面那位老法警资深法警就上前给他补一枪。
Usually, the inmates were died after two shots, but the bailiff fired three times. Not only did Wu not die, but he also kept howling.
那个时候旁边的法医才赶快跑过去拿听筒一听，还没有听到是这个人怎么还一直在动这样。后来那个听筒往旁边移，才发现说哇，吴兴华心脏偏右，所以你打左边针打不死的。所以那个时候赶快法警拿起来就对着那个地新的位置，砰砰两枪之后，哎，吴兴华才过去。
Because the position of his heart was different from ordinary people, Wu struggled for over an hour before he died. But some death row, in order to redeem themselves, hoped to donate organs after death. After all, they had committed many crimes in their lifetime, hoping to eliminate their sins and make contributions to society.
那个时候其实台湾医学界那时候一直在呼吁捐赠器官嘛，医学团体就把脑筋动到死囚身上，因为那时候死囚不少，所以那时候法务部他也接受了，就在监狱里面就推广说死囚你要捐赠器官。
In March 1991, Huang Jia, who was sentenced to death for robbery and murder, expressed his willing to donate organs after death.
死囚如果要捐赠器官的话，他不能直接打心脏，所以他打脑干，打这个从脖子右后方这边打进去，把这个脑干喷水让你脑死。
枪决死囚的时候，事先一定要先看死囚那个人的瞳孔。
看他瞳孔到底在活着的时候是什么状况，因为有的瞳孔是有缺陷的，他死了跟他活着的时候有扩大吉祥的话，你知道他死了嘛，老死了嘛，他不然你灯光一照，他一定要收起来，他不但没有收，而且还扩大，你知道死了嘛，所以不会很难判断。
Experienced forensic doctors know that it is less inaccurate to use pupils to judge whether a death row is dead or not.
你不要以为去摸那个脉搏，去做什么特殊的哦压颈部有什么感觉，那个都不对的，温度不可能的，因为它肝死温度是一样的啦。
What was unexpected was, after one shot,
那这个黄家靖那时候也是打了脑干之后啊，就把他送到龙总啊，因为呢他要捐赠器官，有那个受伤组织在龙总。 送到龙总之后，那个外科部医生就讲，其实他在救护车上面，他的生命迹象就恢复，就慢慢的一直在增强。送到医院的时候，那医生一看说，哇，啊这个已经不是脑死啊，而且那个脑死不是都指数是3吗？他那个时候已经恢复到4、5这样，而且那个状况有渐渐好起来的感觉。医生当然基于医学伦理啊，你这个人没有脑死。
Huang, who was deemed dead, even recovered to breathe spontaneously after arriving at the hospital. He was still alive. How could the operation continue under such
circumstances?以前常常传说说什么开3枪没死，就没有死刑啊，没有这回事啊。最高纪录曾经有开过7、8枪，你不死再拼命开，开到死为止。所以这个黄家靖怎么办？医生不敢摘除他的器官，就叫北所再把他载回去啊。那北所就派真的又派车来，又把他载回去，北所再补一枪啊。 再补了一枪之后，不敢再走，就在那边等观察。法医也在现场说：“哎，确认脑死。”等到他没有恢复的迹象，这一整来来回回折腾了，已经好几个小时过去了，器官根本就不能用了。
The same death row was shot twice. This situation had never happened. Even though the detention center sent Huang, who was confirmed dead, back to the hospital, it was too late, and his wish to donate his organs was not fulfilled. But because of this incident, the organ donation of executed prisoners had caused a lot of controversy. Every second counts for organ donation, and the organs may be damaged in just 1 minute, and the transplantation may fail. However, if the executed prisoners sent to the hospital showed signs of life again, as a doctor, should organs be harvested? Should people be saved? It is challenging the doctor's ethics.
法务这几年就没有再继续推广说要捐赠器官了，因为这中间的争议真的很大。你如果像这个黄家庆，他当时开了枪之后，在北所认为他已经脑死，可是送到龙总的时候，他的生命之血，他的生命力很强盛，很旺盛，他还不想死，因为你是等于活人活摘器官，这是非常大的争议。The
gunmen who carried out executions in Taiwan were all bailiffs. The execution fee for one execution was said to be 3,000 bucks. Many bailiffs were not willing to work as executioners for this money because the work pressure was too much. It is said that a bailiff accidentally violated a taboo during the execution process, and as a result, a series of strange things happened.
那进入刑场之后，阴冷的风哈，感觉上是迎面而来。
Fang Ji, who once served as warden in Taipei Detention Center, had executed more than 20 death row and was used to seeing death. But on the day of the interview, when we asked him about the execution ground, he, who had never been superstitious, said these words.
如果叫我一个人进去，我基本上我也不太愿意。你说什么味道，我也谈不上。就是到殡仪馆停尸间的味道，应该差不多吧，阴冷的。
The smell of death, full of the entire execution ground. In the Taipei Detention Center, since the establishment too of May 2019, 331 death row had been shot here. It was said that the execution ground was full of resentment. So many staff were unwilling to enter unless they had to for work.
哦，他们不敢进去，不敢进去，他都会发抖。你可以访问一下台北所，你到现场看看，你就会感觉到那个味道。
There was once a female supervisor at a detention center who always stayed up all night before executions. If it was during the tomb sweeping festival, she would always ask for leave. She said that she could see things that others could not.
我在台北说某一位主管，女性主管，她如果在执行前一天，我所谓主管是客室主管啊，他们需要轮值的，那这天晚上她就没办法睡觉。
像我们看守所的话，每一年清明节的时候，像我们要拜一些地区公的，那我们拜的话，看守所的收容同学、收容同学拜，那职员部分是职员会买些东西在大门拜，那所长基本上代表机关说，我一般我都会代表他们一起去。那我们去的话，大概都有二三十个人吧，可是那个女性主管她不敢来，她说所长，你们看是二三十个，我看的是四五十个。
As a result, supernatural rumors began to intensify.
不过我在台北看守所当所长的时候，那时候还年轻呢，那良心话我也不太信邪，所以执行枪决的时候我会去看，那个枪从背后打下去之后，那后面会有一个洞，洞会就浮肿出来，然后血从里面流出来。我们看守所都有宗教师在，宗教师跟我讲说。所长你最好不要看，他说人啊是有七魂六魄，其实人接近死亡之后有的魂魄会飞出来，看到你之后他会记得他最后死亡的几个人，如果有很多这个冤气的话，那万一找到你对你并不好，我们当时想是宁可信其有不可信其无。
他还有一个重点哦，想喝麦多要大小心啊，他死得会很不爽，让他很平静，他打完就死了，对不对？然后你如果把他头然后拿起来，把他拉起来哈，来看把酒，掀起来是不啦？哎，阿弟咋死啊？阿弟掀起来伊拢无，啊，阿弟咋哎，可能阿未死啊？这个大亏，摸出来，我的感觉是说你不要靠近，因为那个就是什么呢？那个就是他灵魂出窍，把、啊、这个口气没做好，咋哎根本没死，他就注意看后面瞳孔无亏，佮亏点钱。